Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make 100% efficient sugarcane farm. So basic, what is the basic principle you said? The basic principle is going to be this module. We are going to use this module to build upon this farm. There are many designs with this module, but I have gone ahead and simplified it. So basically what it is going to do is that when our sugar cane grows in phase in front of our observer, the piston is going to break it and then we are going to grow. This is the basic premise. You can see there is some cap contraption I have made right here. This is the basic connection system we are going to use. Minecart track with the unloading station, how it works. Basically the upper minecart grows back and forth, and whenever it picks up items it will drop off and gets empty. It will start going once again, back and forth again. So this is the basic stuff of the collection system. There has been a lot of debate for a long time in the community upon which plots sugarcane grows the fastest. The reality is sugarcane can be planted on six different blocks in the latest update. Red sandstone, red sand, rooted dirt, grass, horizon, and coarse dirt. Sugarcane can be planted on these six blocks. Each module is going to be 15 blocks long. So these are the basic supplies you are going to need. For each module you need, each basic module you need 15 pistons, 15 bits of redstone dust, one observer, 15 sugarcane plantable blocks, for example sand or dirt or grass, etc. And a whole lot of fun. The other redstone supplies are for the collection system. For each module you need about 4 power rails, 11 normal rails, 1 repeater, 1 comparator, and 1 redstone torch, and a whole lot of building. We are going to need to build a collection system first. Is the chest unit to deposit the sugarcane? Sorry, I forgot about that. You also need 1 hopper each module. 1 hopper facing the chest with 1 comparator taking signal from the hopper, a block in front of the comparator, a redstone torch, a block on the face of the redstone torch, a repeater facing towards the hopper, a block in front of the repeater. This is the basic collection system. We have 2 power rails like this. So this is our basic collection system. Next we are going to do is we are going to make a collection track for the upper minecart to travel in, and then after 15 blocks a block to stop the upper minecart. Let me clarify one more thing. A single module of this sugarcane farm is an early game module. Let me remind you on these ones. As you go late game, it won't be able to keep up with your sugarcane demands. Now next we need, I am going to use these stairs to highlight places in which we need what. These stairs are all going to be filled with what. You can say that these are going to be water on stairs. The stairs have been built. Before we fill them with water, we are going to place the blocks on which to plant the sugar cane like that. This is the basic formation for the farm. What it wanna do is that we are going to waterlog all these stairs. These blocks need to be connected with water in order for them to grow any sugar cane. Next we are going to do is that we are going to plant our sugar cane on top of these blocks. Sugar cane has been planted. Now I am going to use this oxidized strut copper as my building block of choice, because I just like the look of it. It is a great addition for the latest 1.17 update. All we need a line of blocks right here. I would advise, instead of any normal blocks, use either glowstone or seal entrance right here, or else the bomb might get too dark and mobs might spawn. This step is done. Next we need to place our pistons, and these pistons are going to be facing towards the sugar cane. Just like that, our 15 pistons have been planted. Next we need is observers facing towards the pistons. These observers are not necessary. You only need 1 observer for this farm to work, and you can place it anywhere you like. I have replaced the excess observers with building blocks. Now we need a line of redstone dust just behind the observer. But what this redstone dust is going to do is that this redstone dust is going to power our pistons as soon as the sugarcane grows. So for example, if this bit of sugarcane grows, you can see all of the pistons got fired. But that's why we do not need 15 observers. We only need 1 observer. Next I am going to encase the armings in glass so that it is visible and how it is working. Before suppose in case the you need to be careful that there is only that there is no space after these sugarcane, or else it might create glass. That's right here. I am only dealing with sugarcane and then immediately placing glass.
12 seconds later,
the farm has been encased in glass so that we can better see easily. Next, we need a minecart hopper to go underneath the custom, and there you go. The farm is complete. Now let me show you it in action. I am going to increase the random tick speed. There you go. I have set the random tick speed to 100. I'm going to do something. I think I'm going to increase the random tick speed even more. Let's say set it to 1000. So that is good. As you can see, the sugar cane grew. The minecart picked up the sugar cane and it deposited it in the collection system. It is done right here because it is unloading all the sugar cane. There we go. Collected and it has been deposited in the collection system.